The inverse of this function would be negative 1, comma 5, 3, comma negative 2, and 2, comma 6. Great thinking if you found these three coordinates. Now, what you want to notice is that the inputs and the outputs switch for the inverse function. In other words, notice how a, b, and c were always the input for the first function we looked at, whereas in the inverse function, a, b, and c were all outputs. Another way of thinking about it is that the x and y coordinate always switched. So here, for x, I had a, and for y, I had 2. In the inverse function, the x value is 2, and the y value is a. This is also true for these other two points. The x value and the y value switched. The same was true for this last point. So to find this inverse function, we simply switch the x and the y values for each coordinate pair. That's how we wind up with this function. Keep in mind that inverse functions undo the original function. So if I put in 5, I get an output of negative 1. So to undo that, when I put in negative 1 to my inverse, I want to get out the output of 5, the original input.